I came for the love. I came for the low, 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 low,
we can be alone. Push it till you're gone. Dripping with a love. I know you wanna go again. We can be alone. Push it till you're gone. Dripping with a love.
I came for the love.
just felt like screaming.
Hey, traders, welcome to episode 738 of the show. You could be doing anything, but you're here again, and I really appreciate it. And it's Monday, man, another new week where the S&P 500 has hit all-time highs. Fitbit is up 40% or so. The fact that I think it was Google, right, made an offer to buy them. And, yeah, pretty nice. Bitcoin still out of the channel. Did a static video, got a 12-minute static video early today on this. Deep, deep analysis. I mean, as much as you probably could ever talk about, you know, we went log scale, linear scale, the 60-minute, 4-hour, the daily. Don't think we talked about the weekly, though, on Bitcoin. We can do that right now. All right, so yesterday this candle closed. So confirmed bullish engulfing candle. And it does seem like we have hidden bullish divergence where you make a low on price, a higher low, a much higher low with much higher levels of negative momentum. So I don't know how that's going to play out. I mean, impending price action continuation. So that means that continuations like higher prices. But again, you've got to make higher highs than your previous highs, which we haven't really done yet. Though I know it's amazing that we had that momentum shift breakout. That's only step one in reversing that trend from the correction to get it back intact with that initial impulse, which was from December of 2018 to June of this year. So, yeah, man. Nike continued to sell off. Oh my God, dude. The asset we looked at this weekend. I don't know. I think Sergio was talking about it or something, dude. Far-fetched. Oh my God, man. I mean, I don't know if we should shift too much away from Bitcoin yet. Kind of feel like guilty of just talking about it that little and then moving on. But I mean, again, I wouldn't feel that like it'd be okay to do it. I mean, unless I did a static video that was 12 minutes earlier today, which thanks for watching. Wow, the thing's getting a lot of views. Actually picking up a lot of subs, I think. I mean, maybe. I don't even know. Nearly 2,000 views. Very cool of y'all to watch that. Yeah, we're like 3 subs away from 20,800, chat. 3 away. So if you're out there and you haven't hit the sub button yet, help the cause, man. Help the cause. We're here every day trying to provide market updates, look for trade setups and opportunities. Good news is XCL's down 2%. Mixed bag, of course, across the markets. Now, Spotify's up like 16%. Google reported earnings. And I know they dropped really bad after hours. I think they had an earnings miss, but are still the pretty big recovery after hours from the low point to near break-even price at the open of the day today. So, yeah, I'd say that good news, man. The major indices are doing things. And, you know, we've got the Fed meeting the 30th and 31st. So in a couple days, we'll be knowing for sure if that Fed cuts rates for the third consecutive time, interest rates. Tom Jones, are you kidding? What the? Oh my God. Let's go.
Bruh. Is that a joint?
If you are watching and enjoy the stream, hit the like button to pay respect to the TA.
Wow. Tom, man. Now I know you, Tom. Now I know who you are. Okay, it makes sense now. Dude, thank you so much for the $61. Oh, the 618. That's the... Shoot, that's the golden retrace contribution. Wow, Julia's got the golden mean ratio. You got the golden retrace. I wonder if we can make a emoji ball for the jar or something for that. Thanks, dude. Wow. Very cool. Hype in the chat for Tom. For Tom. Thank you, dude. Jeez. How many subs needed for the Pepe emojis? We need 30,000 for that. So it'll be a long time, man, before we get 30,000 subs, especially the way things slowed down the past 3 months or so. Yep, Beyond Meat. If you didn't see at the beginning of the show, I had the their little thumbnail, their logo, exploding, right? Yeah, they got killed. So did Grubhub, down 20%, man. Terrible fundamentals, it seems, and misses all around. So, all right, so that's your Bitcoin. I guess we can look at other assets if you want. What? Let's look. Maybe look at the futures first or something. Futures and maybe the dominance and maybe the GBTC. We'll look at those. Yeah. All right. So this is what happened, and we did a vote on this yesterday. A poll, and I've got it up still. Here, I'll just show you. Which gap will fill first on the Bitcoin CME futures? 8,743 or 119,339 Kappa? Turn a blind eye and exclude one of the threes, okay? They don't let you edit after, for good reason probably. So, you know, the majority of people barely picked, we would hit 8,743 first before we were to fill this gap. There's a small gap fill up here to the upside. So up or down, you're closer to the one down here. So I guess in time you could, but it's not a certainty that you'll fill this first or you'll even get down there before running to higher prices. So I'll tell you what you did do on the futures chart is you did close below critical areas, right where we opened, like kind of right at it. Yeah, you eventually sold off and closed at 95.21. Now you're below the critical resistance, and you can see it chop here too, just all over. So it looks like right now the people that voted for 8,743, they're winning, I guess, if you want to call it that. All right, dude, holy crap, chat, we did it. Well, my Lemetric's saying we did it. I don't know, man. GBTC, and we're looking at this log scale. It's beautiful in log scale, man. It's so perfect in log. All right, this is how the day closed. You close at $11.26. Just look at it. Look here. Listen. Excuse me. Where you just had like one and two on the top, and then three on the bottom. And the heart line touches are ridiculous. 25 touch lines, great. And we did close today outside of the channel. That we know GBDC is just going to be reactive to Bitcoin and crypto price action. It's gonna follow and lag behind the spot price. That's how it works. Look low, lower low. Wow, you even had somehow, some way, you made another level of divergence. 1, 2, 3 at the end. Jeez. RSI divergence was very real too, and it was very close to support back from June of 2018. There you have it. So we looked at Bitcoin spot, Bitcoin futures, GBTC, and now we can look at Bitcoin market cap dominance. Just why not? I mean, who cares, right? It's not really that big a deal. Just seeing what it's doing. Remember, like when Bitcoin blasted off, so did the dominance. For it, and you know, now look what we've done. We broke this. I don't know if we're following traditional technical analysis or not, man. I'm just telling you what's actually happening. The price action correlating to the trend lines. That's all I'm doing. You broke it, and you're still above it now. You're just holding right there, right at it. So maybe you're regarding it as a support. Maybe it's a spring or something. I don't know. Last time you did regard it and then ran again. So we'll see what happens here. Probably has something to do with Bitcoin price action, the spot price. Okay, oh my god. Sorry, just drinking some coffee, man. Joanne, it's a lovely, sunny Monday. Hope you are too. Hope you had a good day. It was full of green. Whatever asset you're in. My God, dude. U.S. Steel. If you'd have gotten in U.S. Steel when we got into it, you'd be up 20 effing percent today. Broke out of the wedge, too. It's perfect. Freaking perfect, man. Yes, U.S. Steel Connect. All right, so just looking at Ethereum and log scale on the daily. If you look at it in log scale, nothing crazy going on yet. A little double bottom action going on, not too crazy or anything, you know. Ended up having the same stuff Bitcoin had in the end. Sorry, I don't know why this stuff's not saving or something. I don't get it. Okay, so I can't plot everything in linear scale. You can't make a channel really make sense. So just log scale, potential double bottom with a neckline up here at like 198. I mean, if you did look at it like that, which you could, it's completely fine to look at it like that. You did not break out of anything yet. You just ran up to touch it and then failed. Again, failure is probably because of Bitcoin volatility. I'm sure it had something to do with that. If you look at it like this, you're looking for targets. So 23%. 23%. Okay, so looking for like 240, 244 measure move if you ever break out. Be very interesting, but you know it's not going to be easy to break above that 220, which is previous overhead resistance. I mean, you're struggling at resistance back from October of 2018, April of 2019. I mean, that's resistance now, so it's not easy to break that. And there's candle close back from September 2018, so major battleground area right here for Ethereum. Got to break that, man, and you're not going to be able to do it probably without Bitcoin. All right. Oh my God, Kramer's talking about MACD crossovers, man. What's he talking about, chat? Let me,
It's floor support, and things can go all the way up there. Now, doesn't that intrigue you? Option hounds must like it too. Lang would not be surprised if Polaris gets there in short order because the momentum is strong with this one. All right, here's a little dicey one. I asked him to look at it because I'm just kind of depressed about this one group. It's called Royal Caribbean, all right? And it reports in 2 days. This is a very different picture from Polaris away.
RCL.
Royal Caribbean's had a very, very rough time here, but now there's a W pattern forming. That's a classic bottom formation. Looks just like the letter W.
Royal Caribbean.
And I've got to tell you, I really want this to work because these guys are great guys, but so far this cruise industry has just been a disaster of late.
He's calling a double bottom or something.
This one is trading at 112 and change. It's ceiling resistance at the 200-day moving average, currently at 113.77, up a buck and a half from here. If the stock can break out, Lang thinks that has the makings of a run back to May highs of about 130. So I'm glad I asked about it. If you think I'm right, boom, that could be really significant. Don't forget, the big problem is Caribbean, which
is so weird. A weird way to plot, yeah.
Storms. Royal Caribbean still has a lot of work to do, but it bounced off the twin lows and the W on a decent vibe, which suggests the line that the sellers are likely to
finish. He does that.
The on-balance volume is improving, as is the relevant strength index. That's another key momentum indicator. While Royal Caribbean still has a lot of work to do, Lang sees the momentum shifting.
Momentum shifting. I mean, like, it looks like it could just be another harmonic developing, right, or something. Look left. He's not bringing up the ice line that you've held twice. It's probably too close. Yeah, it's literally too close to be it's more of a potential double bottom. I get that. Yeah. So an atom double bottom or something. Look, it's like you had a downtrend and you broke it. Right, it looked more like a descending broadening wedge, right? That's really what it looked like. Had the fake out, dumped, double bottom, and now you've broken out And I guess what he did say was the momentum shifted. Yeah, it did. The momentum shifted, but at this point, you know, there's resistance up here. So you, look, if you were thinking about this thing in a range, and it held here and confirmed the second time, yeah, there is upside potential, but now there's not, you know, there's not much value, as much value now as there was down here. So it's kind of like, sure, it could run all the way up to like 130 RCL. Great, man. I mean, measure move of the pattern would put you up there, right? Oh my God, this is log. Yeah, no real difference. It's not a big change in price. So measured move, yep, put you up there, right? That's it. So big resistance at 115.65. You'll probably get there, especially the macro holds up. But soon you could be developing bearish divergence if you aren't already, right? Or bearish convergence with a lower high right now. Okay. Sorry, just looking at what Cramer is looking at, kind of funny. I don't know. I never watch him. I just have on like CNBC, and he's on right now, so. You get it, like low risk areas. You held it here, blasted up, dumped again, and then you sprung. But then we came back to it, right? For the first time, you know, once we broke back above it in January 2019, we never back tested this trend line until August. Think about that. And then we confirmed it not once, but actually twice on some kind of flash crash or something. So kind of a triple bottom down here. All right, anyway, just looking here, listening. So Farfetch is what we looked at this weekend. Great start to the week with a perfect breakout, right? It's right at entry or whatever, because we looked at it, you know, I think Friday or something. Big green candle up 6.63% today, but closed at the October 17th little peak right there. So you got to break that. Then you got to break 880. And you might have a nice potential run up to 1030. But the measure move of this wedge is, you know, pretty high. It's 4-to-1 reward to risk. Divergence with the wedge on a gap down. That's crazy, man. That's freaking really nice potential setup. But, you know, the fundamentals are really bad. I think the shareholders are maybe filing a lawsuit against the company, which is never good at all. Yeah, dude, get my trade signals from Cramer, man. That's it, dude. No, I mean, like, things are pretty good on, I mean, decent for the market updates and stuff on CNBC until his show comes on, literally when my show is live. So, it just came on. It's at AVT. EA, yeah, EA's doing fine, man. Doing great. You know, it's still that, I think, momentum shifting on EA right now going into holiday season. I mean, since the entry, it's up like almost $2 since the entry of this trade. It's slow going, you know, they don't always just take off immediately when you go long, but nice bullish convergence here, a higher low than your previous low with higher levels of strength. Good to see. And you're just waiting to see what play out. Sit in your position, you wait, you have your stop loss set up, 88.95, and you go with God. If it gets to the neckline, I'll probably move my, if it gets to 100 bucks, I'll move my stop loss up to break even around 95, and that'll be it. And then I will want it to break the neckline, and if it fails, I get stopped out, I'll lose no money, and then we move on with our day and look for other trades. But yep, this is a freebie, I guess, whatever you want to call it. This one I'm in, I think a couple other people tailed me on it, and the measure move of this pattern puts you up at 116.32, and I was just thinking a secondary target from your high to low, just kind of thinking about a gap fill way up at like 128. There is definitely a gap fill up there, so that was me, you know, using, that was like my thought process on targets: measure move, gap fill. All right, remember, this thing lost so much value. All-time highs 152, 151, and got as low as 74 bucks for rallying and this huge impulse up. And now you have downslipping consolidation after the huge impulse. And now I think this higher low right here signifies the momentum shifting in a good way. Versus you're not making, look, low, or lower low, lowest low. Now, higher low, what? Higher low? So what is that inferring? That's like, hey man, the bears tried their best and now they can't push it down. There's not enough sellers anymore. Now there's accumulation maybe beginning to occur on an asset that has lost a lot of value. Okay. And macro is starting to look better just for the fact that S&P 500 all-time highs and the bull trend could continue. Right. Fed gonna cut rates almost certainly day after tomorrow, or maybe Halloween. Crap, I gotta figure out a Halloween costume, chat. I don't even know. No idea what I'm gonna do. Wow. Confirmation. There doesn't have to be confirmation when you're buying on the right shoulder. That's the strategy. And like the pivot point was here. It was good, real good. Sure, I could sell off one more time, but my stop loss is below the $90 mark, the lowest low of the left shoulder. So I'm safe there. You think. All right. Sometimes you just don't make the same exact low. Sometimes it's sort of scuffed and a little off. Dude, the Star Wars game's coming out. Need for Speed's coming out. They're not really, that's not really that big time. It's not like Call of Duty, and that's why we own Activision too. We can shift gears for a second again. Where is it? Show yourself on my watch list. There it is. NeoConnect, of course, down 4% today. I mean, yeah, that happens. That happens when you go from $6.80 on Friday. And then by today, you're at $13.44. Okay, you round doubled in value in a few days. You got extremely overbought. Hey, we talked about when you get overbought, you don't stay that overbought for very long, right? That's very high. So maybe what'll happen is on the breakout, if we're not done, we just indecision, and then we just cool off on the daily oscillator, probably the 4-hour oscillators, and then we start flagging, create some sort of consolidation before running again to higher prices. Always possible. This thing had a very, very deep retrace from the previous low to high. How deep? 88% retrace, chat. The 88% retrace that was confluent with the 1618 fib extension. Dude, look for confluence. Fibonacci, it's really, really strong. It's good stuff. And then the divergence on the tail end for the RSI was nice, with no negative momentum on slightly lower lows. Very good. So Bitcoin's down about $80 on this day, not even 1%. So with an hour and a half left until your daily close, you got to think, will we make another higher high? We need a rally within 1.5 hours to do that. A higher high than the previous highest close from yesterday. Oh, be Vegeta, man. Be Vegeta, man. So Renee, Cosmic Elf, there you go, dude. There's your Neo. Okay, we're gonna get XRP now.
Maria,
Brad.
Hey Mitch, it's been a while since I've tuned in. Have you looked at BAT lately? Thanks.
Oh, we certainly have, for good reason. Trade setup, monitoring it intently daily. Bat is the Kang. The Kang of what? The Kang of the bats. Sorry. So beautiful, man. Extremely large, complex pattern. Again, bat to the US dollar, bullish bat pattern. Hit the 88% retrace. Hit the 200% retrace pretty much from B to C. And had a resounding bounce where you have from the lowest point, from the entry of the trade setup to the highest point, bat had increased in value 82.42%. And right now where it's at, it's still at 63% gained from the entry of the trade setup. So I'd say that's pretty freaking good. Now, of course, you know, like, you got to use your critical thinking, you know, having targets so high. I mean, it may never get up to those levels. So taking a little off, layering out a little bit at, you know, fib nodes is completely reasonable, especially when you're up almost 100% or when you were up almost 100%. You know, it's like you got to use critical thinking. Sometimes you got to call audibles and it's like, man, I've made so much money on this trade in a pretty decent amount of time. You know, nothing wrong with calling audibles. Like, dang, man, I mean, Bitcoin did on Friday. And you think, oh, the trade setup, you can call audibles. If you had higher targets or something, say, oh, well, you know, if we're at 43% in less than 24 hours, you know, this might definitely pull back a lot, which it did. It pulled back 50% of the way at its deepest point, you know, from that Friday morning low to the Friday night high or whatever. Thank you, Maria. So bad, yes. Doing things, been doing things. Can't stop, won't stop. Right, Renee, and all I'm talking about is this one. You know, you just look here, you listen. I'm right there, posted it August 30th. Bam, right? Though, again, that's what I'm saying. Like, if you're up 80%, you know, you may never hit these levels. So you just gotta use your own discretion on where you take profit. Even though it could go up there. I mean, on a traditional market, assets like this that are this large, almost 1 year large patterns do eventually get up to these levels, but maybe not in crypto. Maybe not. You didn't even hit a 38% retrace from that high to low, which is crazy, right? You hit the most shallow retrace and now you're kind of bouncing off that most shallow retrace. So the next target for BAT is 28.3 cents, 28.4 cents, excuse me. All right. These are random, Fritz? What do you mean random? I'm not just looking at random assets. Fitbit, yep. They say buy the rumor, sell the news. Oops, sorry. Holy crap. Dude, I've had this charted, I don't know how long, but look at this. Oh my God. Chat, Fitbit is your...
Look here! Look, listen!
Asset of the day. I don't remember the last time I charted this, but you have to see what it did, okay? Now it's move up to 40%, 43%, just like Bitcoin. That's great. But look where it pulled back. This is the first time I'm looking at this today. Fitbit, just to look at his chart, all right? That is beautiful, dude. So freaking perfect. Hit that supply line like to Jesus, man. So though there was rumors that could not ever, you know, the TA could never predict Fitbit doing this, the TA definitely was respected at its top for now. Of $1.33. Again, it closed the day up 30.86%. Beautiful, man. What's up, Beeswaxers? Oh my God, Jordan, 150th like. Thank you, dude. Palladium hit the all-time highs today. Nice, dude. Gold had a fake out, dude. Seriously, had a fake out. Let me make sure. I have to refresh something, I think. Yep, there it is. Get that out of here. Okay, we're good. Perfect. Thanks for the 500 people tuned in. If you're enjoying the live stream, hit that like button, that bell, that sub, man. Thanks so much. Let's get to 30K subs so we can get the Pepe memes and emotes that y'all can spam in the chat. I know Google announced a bid to buy Fitbit. It's not official. They're looking to acquire, but they haven't yet confirmed, right? Monolithic power systems, since you keep asking for it. Higher lows, higher lows, higher lows. Clear uptrend at a set anchor point 1 and 2 on the bottom, 3 on the top. Okay, we're respecting that 75% trend line. Heart line somewhat. I'm not including any of this stuff back here. Don't think about that. It's not part of it. It's really just where the volatility, big impulse down started. And that's it for this channel. So, I mean, I don't know, you're approaching 52-week highs again. And 161 is it. And you know, if you break to all-time highs, then you can, probably a couple ways, you can Fibonacci high to low here. You can get your targets, 1272, 1414, 1618. So, all right, that's it, man. I mean, there is, every time you sell off, you're making higher lows. And you just keep getting closer and closer to all-time highs again. It kind of just reminds me, it looks a little bit like the macro itself, the S&P 500 itself. It's just a little bit behind, you know, that's what it looks like to me. So still very bullish and not overbought on the daily. Positive momentum's building. It could continue to rally, but if it's not going to, if it's going to reverse, it's going to be close. It's going to be soon. It's going to be 156.42 or right around 159 where it sells off, because it's a sell off. You retrace commonly, you're already out of the common retrace level. You're the deep retraces. Joy Tomkinson, thanks for the sub. Welcome. Thanks for all the new subs today. Y'all are incredible. Let me ban a scammer. Hold on. Unless it was already squashed. It looks like it was already taken care of. Sometimes the scammers will get auto banned. I think like the algos figure it out or something. All right, so with XRP still just struggling, man, at a downside resistance, you know, I had it like that, and it was like a false breakout. But then it's like, do you just adjust now? If you adjust, then it's like you're not out of anything yet. If you don't, are you already broken out? 1 and 2. It's really, really choppy, man. Extremely choppy. So, I mean, I guess you could look at it like left shoulder, head, maybe right shoulder, and then like neckline, and you've kind of broken the neckline. I don't know, man. It's weird. And we've just been looking at the Poloniex chart anyway. But if you go from your high to low, we just know the common retrace level is between 32.589 cents. Yes, 589. And 39.625 cents. So I don't think this thing is maybe done yet. But I really think you got to have Bitcoin performance for XRP to pop to the upside. Okay. The X Army, full effect. That's right, Fritz. We doing things. 20% gains. We hadn't even been in the position that long. It's a position trade. It's like you're supposed to hold X for maybe a year. How can there be a diamond if you don't have a higher high in the middle of your pattern? You have to have a higher high. Unless you're just talking about one and two here. One and two, one and two, one and two. I don't know, man. It's whatever. Are you talking about this, dude? It's just so arbitrary, because that's like all like new stuff. I don't know. The only way you can make this into a diamond is like that. There's no other way. Like, because you can't use this stuff up here. Because it doesn't even make sense. You can't have the highest high and a diamond be at the top. Talking about something like that, dude. Whatever, man. Maybe. I don't really care, man. It's just at such a low... It's been at such a low area of value for so long now. Based on the chart we know and love. Oh my god, man. I cannot get the music to stay tame. It's always bullcrap. It's just this one, man. This is it. Drew W, man. Thanks for the 420.
Is that a joint?
It's not showing up on Stream Elements for some reason. I don't know why. It should have already popped up. I'm sorry, man. I don't know. But I did receive that contribution and really appreciate it. It does that once every blue moon. Like, sometimes just a contribution won't show up. It won't go through Stream Elements. It'll go through it, but it just won't work. Kind of annoying. I don't know, man. This is the lifetime history chart where you had the horizontal line supports and you also had the upsloping support, the potential demand line. It seems like that demand line's holding up until it's not. Continuing to rise, you gotta keep rising. You'll skid away from it, man. Skid away from it. But, I mean, you can see on the daily, just in long scale, kind of zoomed out. Like, this is how. I mean, look, dude, it's. Is this not like real? Where you had a low, a lower low, a lowest low, and now you've made a higher low. And the higher low is to do what? You broke back above critical supports, then you kind of like back tested them briefly, and you bounced resoundingly. And now you're back above all this crap. So that's good. It's a really good sign. So now you're just going to have to continue upsloping no matter what now. You don't want to break this, I don't think. All right. That's it. There's your XRP. USD. Couch cushions. You crushed 20 wings last night? Yeah, dude. Yeah. I think I'm breaking out because I ate those wings. Like on my forehead again. But yeah, man, we did a 6 hour plus live stream last night. It was like 6 hours and 40 minutes or something before I ended. I don't even know anymore. It was just a long one, dude. Long stream. I guess if you want, since we looked at XRP to USD, let's look at XRP to BTC, because it was in development of some sort of reversal. But as you can see, when Bitcoin pumped, hey, that's okay. That's completely okay, man. Hey, remember, what the heck, dude? We had this plot and we're like, you know, you could always come back down to this area. Dang, dude, can someone find that when we analyzed this last? And you got close, and just talking about momentum shifting, even if you dump here, if you make a higher low, man, that's confirming more momentum shifting. Remember, there's different types of momentum shifts. One being a downsloping resistance breakout and backtest. That's one way. But another is confirming higher lows than your previous lows, we could easily do that here in the situation. Great. This was definitely something, a scenario we talked about where it could be left shoulder, double head, right shoulder, very close. Wow. Someone find it. Canatomo. I don't know. So it's kind of scuffed, kind of a scuff pattern because of this higher high, but it's whatever, man. Just make a higher low and you've definitely got a good chance to keep going. I mean, this thing's only been selling off for like...
Is that a joint?
10 months, 11 months?
Everyone has a soft spot for XRP, but don't tell people.
Don't tell people, they will be coming at us, Adrian, with pitchforks. Yeah, you just gotta think about it logically with Bitcoin being at nearly $10,000 and you think about XRP at like 25 cents when it was there forever and you had so many chances and we kept showing the Poloniex chart over and over and over and it's like, hey man, low risk area, can't argue with that, right? Only been correcting for like 2 years almost now. The growth one could gain if XRP has residual effect of Bitcoin price action, positive price action, you could grow a lot. You know that position could grow more maybe than Bitcoin. You know, in order for XRP to double, all it has to do is go to like nearly 60 cents. You know, Bitcoin has to go like to all-time highs to double at this point or close to it. So you just got to think about it like that. Nothing wrong with Bitcoin though. Big one's amazing. What the heck? I'm just telling you, thinking about it like that. Like, you've got a multiplier. So, thank you, Adrian. And thanks again. Again, Drew W. I don't know why your tip didn't go through Stream Elements. Very grateful. Yeah, we can look at the S&P. Find out what it means to me. So, let's look at the SPY first. Here it is, chat. Well.
Look here! Look, listen!
Gapped up today. Gapped up over the resistance. Could pull back to, you know, 3,000. Maybe to backtest the trend line that we broke. But this is it. I mean, this is like a... You know, we got the ascending... Or sorry, we got the rising wedge. I think it's real. But I also think that the ascending triangle developed too. Where it was like X, A, B, C, D. And now it's too... Nope, can't make it a harmonic. Can't be. Alright, so, you know, first target is going to be like 3,070.
Thanks for helping us learn how to do things. Appreciation.
Anonymous, thanks for the 690 pennies. Sexual amount of pennies. Verge, Pornhub, you get it, chat. Haha, hilarious. So funny. Well, would it be terrible that the stock market's making all-time highs? Some earnings are okay. They're coming in well and soft. What is it, hidden, stealth, quantitative easing, where, you know, record buyback levels, you know, where the institution or the organization themselves will buy back their own stocks, but they'll get, on the back end, they'll get government tax breaks. So it's just a way of easing. And this is what happens, what we've been talking about, man. It's like all the powers that be are doing everything they effing can to get this to all-time highs. Right, it's like so blatant and clear. So that's one way to look at it. And I think that the Fib extensions are good. And what else could be there is an upsloping resistance. This idea, of course. You get it, right? Up here, way up here. So like 3,116 if like the trajectory just kept going like this or something. You know, maybe by mid-November we could hit a 1,414.31. 15, and that would also be confluent with an upsloping resistance, and that might be where we pull back, maybe to back test or something. Look, the divergence that you were having is now, you never got rid of the negative momentum at all. It just stayed sideways and now it's building again. So divergence off the table for now until something changes. It's now completely invalidated for the most part on the RSI and MACD. Maybe, just maybe it gets some, but it might be at much higher prices. This is a big deal, man. All right. We've, you know, from January 2018. All-time highs. We didn't see all-time highs again until September of 2018, and it was a 2% gain all-time high before dumping again. Then we ran up May of 2019. 2% gains, if that. It was all, no, it wasn't 2% there, but it was 2% here. From these highs to this high, 2% gains dumped. And now here we are. Will we go higher than 2%? Possibility. Yep, sure, stock market will keep going up as long as they print money. I mean, it seems like it, right? It's pretty wild. But hey, we can't change any of that, so why don't we just make money while it's happening? You know, there are individual assets that don't do exactly what the S&P does, right? Like Nike. What the heck, man? Nike, again, more selling. Perfect. Ungodly, legendary. I mean, this is a legendary short right here because of what happened when we hit the golden mean ratio, the exact entry of the bearish deep crab. Mark Parker, the CEO, who had been CEO of Nike for 13 years or whatever, stepped down. He resigned right here, chat. Not here, not here. No, literally here. And since then we sold off. Okay, we're approaching the area we thought would be the first spot before you might reverse, maybe, because it's a sport, 89.66. We got a gap fill down around like 87 bucks or so at that candle close. 50% retrace, 87.44 right around there too. So I don't think this is done, right? There's no 4 hour, no 4 hour bullish divergence yet. No, not yet. So, but we do think, look, you know, if it's starting to wane, then maybe go up a little bit, you know, while you lose the negative momentum, and then it just starts, the selling starts picking up again and we get down to those lower levels, right? So there's no impending price action reversal on any time scale really that's significant, leading you to believe that the selling may not be done for Nike for now, even though you, again, might get a small little move up before dumping once more. You want emojis? Well, give me the 30K subs for inspection and you shall have them. All of them. We refuse to lose. Hey, remember, if you want to be part of one of the most active trading and crypto communities that are out there, join our Discord. The link is in the description below, but we also post the link all the time. It's the best way to get in contact with me and anyone else in this live chat. But also the most important thing is you will get a notification in that Discord when I go live or create a video. When on YouTube, you will not. You will miss out on probably half the streams I produce because YouTube notification systems are notoriously garbage. Join the Discord if you never want to miss my live stream. What's up, Raymond dudes? Luckin' coffee. Well, high point to low point, 38% retrace. And yep, last 2 days of selling. Lower high, downtrend. So this thing has not broken out of its correction, as we discussed. It has not broken the neckline of the potential pattern, which is not real yet. Saying it go down to $12. Wow. Well, if this downtrend stays intact long enough, yeah, it will. So if that was it, I mean, you know, but the thing is you go up and then you sometimes sell off from a low to high. Maybe you're at a 38% retrace now. Maybe you go to 50%, 618, make a higher low, and then you run again, you know? So you just gotta hold strong. I mean, like if you got in down here, which I think you did, you know, moving a stop up to break even or something, there you go. No harm, no foul, but you missed out on some serious gains if it ever gets down back to 1820, which it could, because correction. But I don't know, the initial impulse was bullish and then you bottomed and then you confirmed to the market, this is the bottom with a divergence. Now you're rallying. So earnings, November 12th. It'd be cool to see this just run up to earnings and then by the time, like, you know, the last few days before earnings, maybe it dumps. Well, maybe that's when we would take profit and then it dumped on earnings. Not, you know, maybe leading up, it's going to continue this type of stuff, right? If YouTube was in charge of the emergency broadcast system, we'd all be wrecked. Yeah, TK, exactly. We'd be so effing screwed. Yeah, Joe M did not get a notification today, but he did if he was in the Discord. He certainly did. That's why you all need to join. We post trade ideas, talk about breaking news, all kinds of stuff. Our general becomes a freaking madhouse when there's any kind of volatility. It's amazing. Rami, no one knows that, dude. Gnarly. Freaking gnarly, dude. Big correction and continuing. Aurora Cannabis. Aurora.
Is that a joint?
Yes, kind of. So the downtrend continues, the correction continues. You ran up, reasonable retrace, deep retrace from the high to low, and then dumped. Little demand line, you broke the demand line, back tested it, said nah, and then dumped again, continuing to correct. I don't think there's any type of harmonic going on, like anywhere. This is too deep of a retrace from here to here. There doesn't make any sense. Nope, no harmonic. But like there might be some support maybe down here, finally. So let's just do Fib extensions, previous low to high. Okay, 1272 is $3. Okay, so it seems very, very reasonable to believe at this point on ACB that it should go lower, right? It could go lower. I mean, you got to think about, there's no looking left, looking here, listening. There's no support. You just kind of filled a gap maybe or something. I don't care. There's no divergence now. It's like not at all. It's like all convergence. And so maybe there's more value at $3 because the 1272, look how it lines up with this November 2016 peak. And then you go even lower. Look where these previous highs line up at the 1414 Fib extension at $2.22. So yeah, it could easily go much lower. But it did fall out of the downtrend. So a lot of times when that happens, you know, they're like false breakouts. You can run back up, test 492 before selling off again, maybe. But it's just in a correction, man.
Noise!
Sprint trying to do things. I'm more and more excited about stocks. Thanks, man.
You should, Anonymous. You should. Where do you think all my passion came from? You think my passion came from crypto TA? Get out of here with that. No way. My passion came from the stock market. Learning all this stuff on the stock market, not crypto. We're just applying the stuff we learned on the stock market for years in crypto now. We are Lewis and Clark. We're literally cutting, clearing the thicket, man. Tried, failed, right? Ran all the way up to 655 today and then bearishly engulfed. Gross. But yeah, maybe it's impulse up, flagging. Maybe it's going to try to run again. Not sure. I mean, I'm in it. I'm sitting in it, just hanging out. I've been in it, man, since like 580 something. It's up, but not that much. You broke out. Then you created an extremely large harmonic. Not as big as the crypto ones, the altcoin ones, but this one started in May of this year. XABCD. Cypher. 78% retrace, 1272 Fib extension. So some confluence down here for the zone. We bounced for sure. And the divergence to boot, tail end RSI divergence, just a little bit of it. So Kangish, but close. We're not there yet, man. Don't get cocky, kid. Yet. Don't get cocky. All right. So you just never know, man, like what this could do. It could do like TripAdvisor did, where it runs up and sells off, makes a slightly higher low than the previous low, kind of giving confirmation in the market, and then it goes to higher prices. That's a very real possibility. But we know if we anchor point one and two, we've broken out. We had a Momo shift, a little minor Momo shift breakout right there. You see it? And you could probably just one and two here, and it's like a wedge, right? You broke a wedge, whatever pattern, and you're not even at the retrace level. It's common retrace. So 668 to 722 is the retrace zone. So still more upside potential, but we don't know exactly when it's going to happen. All right. That's Sprint. Hey, if you're enjoying the live stream, hit that like button, that bell, that sub. Let's go, man. Let's go, sub spike. The road to 30K every day. Dang, dude. So much support for the static video. I dig it, man. Almost 300 likes on that. Amazing, dude. So, you know, those Chinese stocks were up a lot yesterday. They have pulled back somewhat. Hey, let's look at Tomo to the US dollar tether. Who was it that asked about this, chat? Oh my God. That's it, man. That's it. Perfect. It's Tomo chain. Give me a break. Some S coin. Bullish divergence. Near the bottom. Done, son. It's done. Today was crazy. Yeah, fake out. Big fake out on gold. All right, nothing more to talk about, really, I guess. Unless you want to talk about the measured move, if it ever did break this, which I don't know if it will. And, you know, it's whatever. If it does, it's very, very simple. Just look at this like a range or double bottom. It doesn't matter. The size of the range, 42%. Kidding? That's a measured move right there, dude. So, what was the chance it'd go to 48.98 cents, man? But these are high-risk areas, extremely high-risk areas for long. I mean, hey, there, I guess there was the opportunity at these levels, sure. And when we looked at it on Friday night or something, it's gone now. It's done. Did it, Stay Dumb Kings, man. We did it, dude. It had a trading competition that started today on Binance. Is Bitcoin ready to break the 9500 resistance? Maybe. I remember on the 60-minute what it was doing. It was showing hidden bullish divergence on the RSI, and it was showing bullish convergence on the MACD. And then on the 4-hour, Bitcoin was like showing bearish divergence. But if you're in a bull trend, the divergence does often play out, but it barely does anything, right? It barely affects the price. It gets a sell-off just a little bit, and then we'll go again. And so I don't know if that divergence played out yet. right? Going from like 9,900 all the way down to 9,200 might have been that 4-hour divergence. It's unclear, right? So let's just go to Tron Connect, I guess. Tron Connect, dude. Oh my God, look how close it was to the measured move. It got to 2.2 cents with a measured move at 2.2728 cents. So not quite perfect, but geez. Slanted inverse head and shoulder connect. And of course, the mega pattern. It wasn't conventional, right? It never stopped at a 786 or even an 886 for that matter. It made a 95% retrace from the previous low. But it did reverse with bullish divergence at the 1414 Fib extension from B to C, a very critical spot. And that's the 1414, man. It was confluent with 786 back in December when we called that bottom on the Gartley. 1414 is a beautiful special number. 1414, we should make, I don't know what we would do for 1414 for a tip, you know, like for the jar, like an emoji for Chaylin to make. I've got any ideas? 1414. Oh yeah, the streaming industry. I'm talking about like streaming like videos, movies, stuff like that. Yeah, it's becoming super saturated. You can tell everyone wants in on it. Let's just go to people saying Bitcoin divergence on the 1 hour. I mean, hidden divergence. I don't think there's any way you can have bullish divergence classic on 69. Fly on your wall. Thanks for the sub, dude. Welcome. Say something in chat if you're actually here. You may not be. Let's go to that 60 minutes. This is the corn. No. So please don't get the misconception about what divergence actually is. Classic divergence. You cannot. It is impossible. Complete fallacy to believe that if you make a low on price, with a big spike in negative momentum on the histogram, and then you make a clear, concise, higher low, and then you start creating that matured second histogram wick, and it's lower, that's convergence, man, right? When your price action, right? Convergence is when everything's going parallel with each other. They're going together, right? That's convergence, okay? They're on the same page, saying the same thing. They're not diverging. But at the same time, when you make a higher low on either oscillator, you make a low, this level of RSI, then you make a clear, concise, higher low, and you make lower levels of negative momentum. That is hidden bullish divergence. So the 60 minute, I guess, is good because it's telling us two bullish things. But again, at the same time, it's the 60 minute. It's not that great. It's not like the 4 hour or the daily. That's really where we get the big reversals, the big moves to the upside, the big confirmations, right? We're like just price action can really occur. 60 minute, if it plays out, it might only go up to 9,910K again before selling off. That's the only problem with 60 minute. So what you do is use the 60 minute to help us see touch points on trend lines, rounding action, all these different things, but we don't use it so much to be really confident that a big move's coming one way or another. You look at the 4 hour and the daily for that. But man, if you can get the 60 minute and the 4 hour together, really strong. 60 minute, 4 hour daily together, holy crap. And then if you get the 60 minute, the daily, the 4 hour, the weekly all together, holy crap. And we know the weekly showing that hidden bullish divergence, just kind of like little brother, the 60 minute. Same thing, one's on the MACD, the weekly, and the 60 minutes, the RSI, hidden divergence. Was I watching stock? No, I was. I had just begun to pledge a fraternity in 2008. I played football at Bama for my first 2 years, and then junior year was fraternity. And no, during the stock market crash, I was, I think, going through hell week. You know, I was like in my boxers, like getting hazed in our kitchen or whatever. What happened, Philip? $900 billion. Oh, we got you $900 billion on defense. Yeah. Well, guess what? Defense is not going to be so conventionality is going to be different. It's not going to be like guns and planes and all that now and ships. It's now going to be information and data. And China's doing everything they possibly can. They're coming at us. They're coming at the U.S. and the West with everything, you know, financial, just the economic, and of course, you know, military and stuff. Trying to create, I don't think anyone's going to be able to compete with America's military right now. The snowball effect is just, it's gone. It's crazy. But they're going to try in other ways to beat the U.S. And 5G, maybe, try that. You know, any company that's Chinese is pretty much owned by the Chinese government. They can do anything they want. So you'd never want China getting into like 5G with like the big companies like Tencent. What is it? Weibo? Well, I can't remember the name of all those major Chinese conglomerates that control like data and information and media. But that is going to be how they do things. Yeah, James, no fun. Doesn't matter which class. Of course it matters. That's why there's different classes of it. Class A, B, and C, divergence. Those three, and then there's hidden divergence. There's hidden bullish divergence, hidden bearish divergence. So there's 3, 4, 5 different types of divergence. I mean, if you include the bearish side, then double it, you know. Baidu, sorry, Mark. My bad, dude. Are we cool now? Sweet, man. But we have 46 minutes left until your daily close. 46 chat. Waiting on that with you. See if we get some volatility. See if we can continue to move up. The 60-minute says we could move up. And pending price action continuation. Starting to round out a little bit after making a higher low, a clear higher low. And then some people could say super duper scuffed.
Noise!
Handle. I don't know.
Thoughts
about that.
On Netflix Connect. Possible short opportunity.
What's up, Drew, man? Thanks for the threes. Possible short opportunity? I don't think so, man. I don't know about that. I don't think you're at areas of value for a short. That's just me, though, man. Right? You know, we're looking for areas of value. So we're looking at shorts at critical resistance points. We're not looking to go short on assets that at one time from December 2018 to its highest point in July 2019, that just from July 2019 lost almost 88% of its value in 2 months. We're not looking to short assets like that. It's just lost too much value. I mean, dude, there's always the chance that, look at this, X, A, B, C, and then D, right, is a 1272. I mean, that could be some sort of a butterfly, a bearish butterfly. So I don't think, I don't think there's value in shorting right now. Remember, you were looking for things that are overextended. You were looking for things that have been developing bearish stuff for a while. You are looking for things like Texas Instruments that from its previous high to low was at a 1.618 Fib extension, was showing triple MACD bearish divergence, RSI bearish divergence, was on the weekly. From its major high to low, not only were you hitting a 1.618 from this high to low, you were hitting the 1.272 major Fib extension. So these were confluent on the weekly, bearish divergence on both oscillators at the end. That's what you're looking for shorts. All right. This, too much value loss in too quick a period, extremely high risk to go long, to go short at these areas. That's just IMO, even if it does keep selling off. Okay. Does that help? Drew, let me know, man. Thanks. Excuse me. We're also double topping, rising wedge, blah, blah, blah. 9 coinciding variables in the end for Texas Instruments. Thanks for the nearly 600 people tuned in. 218 likes. Is it possible, chat? It might be, it might not be, to get 300 likes on this stream. Again, we have the power, the technology, the peoples, everything we need to hit it, but it's all going to be how you feel deep down. I believe in you, chat. Oh my God. So let's shift gears. Let's go back to crypto for a second. Let's go to Monero. Yes, old Monero. Look here, listen. Okay, so something's happened on Monero. You've kind of bottomed out. It looks like you bottomed out. I mean, my God. Clear bullish divergence on the RSI on the daily. You made slightly lower lows. You had positive momentum only. Better than Class A. It's a Class A plus bullish divergence. And yes, I never adjusted here because it was a head fake. Clear head fake, man. One green candle up, one red candle down. And then from there, you dumped and started hitting the hard line again. So much respect everywhere. Gotta freaking love this channel. That's why I didn't touch it. So now I think we did break out, but not what did we do on the breakout?
Bruh.
All right. First candle, big green one. Second, back tested the trend line that was once a resistance, has now become support. And then the third candle, break, hook, and go confirmation. The strongest form of confirmation you could get on a breakout. That's XMR, man. So if this was to actually make a common retrace because it broke out of the structure, you're looking for just $77 to $94 in time if this this macro holds up. It's a big if, man. But you got to think, with all the violence of Friday, I'm talking like the volume, the buying pressure that came in after hitting a 62% retrace and a 121-day correction after that divergence, man. You got to think, man, that there is a more elevated chance now that we have ended the correction. Like, those impulses like that aren't jokes. Of course, we get sold off again, man, but you really got to think, man, like, it's just the wave analysis, the trend, how it goes, right? You have your big impulses up, and then you correct 61% of the way, and then you go again. Right, the first impulse, that first 6 months of the year for Bitcoin, set the tone for the correction we just were in. And now we're out of it. We just backtested it on the 4 hour. Sure, we could backtest it again and keep backtesting it. That's fine. I mean, I know we did that back in, I think it was like March or something, when we finally broke out of that downsloping channel. If you were watching, you know what I'm talking about. Backtested it twice and then showed some 4 hour divergence. And then that was it. We broke off of it once more. And then April 1st came around and you know what happened. Chris Richard, just rewind the stream if you want to see the S&P 500. We looked at the S&P. Look at the SPX and the SPY. So, two different looks. I think you would like it. Redbeard's back. So is Bitcoin. That would be weird, right? I grow my beard back and then Bitcoin stops, it ends its correction. You know, when I shaved my beard, I can't even remember. Do y'all remember the events of me shaving my beard? Mr. Wolver, NBC killing me, dude. I mean, not killing me. I'm just saying it killing me, dog. That's what I'm saying about it. It's just not going well. Continuing to rise. Soon will be stopped. Square, I know it fell below the stop. I did not get stopped out. Look, I was talking, the stop was slightly below 58.44. It did go right below 58.44. There was just barely any time like that it was below it before bouncing. And look, the move up was so beautiful. I'm just like, okay, all right. I'm monitoring this one, you know. I think it's perfect, dude. Besides it being a slightly lower low than I wanted it to be, still perfect. Ali Ben, thanks for the sub. Welcome.
Grab dumpster fire, please. Down over 30% after hours. Looking for a long entry at areas of value for common retrace.
We were already at those, if you believe it or not, on Grub. We were already at deep retrace levels and areas of value, but yeah, we'll look at it. HG, thanks for the 318. And the memes, man. the beard as an indicator. I'm like, good. So it's not just a potential inverse head and shoulders, slanted inverse head and shoulders. It's also the correlation to the trend lines looking left, looking here, listening. Look, you know, this is really where it seems you held support back from March of 2018. That's where the arrow is. But just above that, you had the ice line, I think, from June of 2018 and June of 2019 and August 2019. And you've broken back above it. It was like you fell below it and then back tested the spring. Kind of, but not really. And now you're just running again, which is fine. Target on this is 74.44 for a measured move. And maybe it would top out before then, but there's a gap fill way up at like $81. Freaking insane. Also, I guess a gap fill at 69.57. That's still a gap fill. Yep. So easily there. 50% retrace. Yeah. You'd think that maybe it, you know, 61.8% retrace is also reasonable. It was still 3-1. Reward to risk, man. Or higher. Yeah, Wolver, but dude, at this point for me, I'm like not liking it. Right? It's like, yeah, of course, it could very well dump, right? We saw with Texas Instruments. But Texas Instruments didn't go too much higher than my entry. MPC is going way high. So like at this point, I'm like, my position's not doing well. So I definitely couldn't afford to gamble on earnings. Right. So that one's just getting me, dude. Wolver. It'll be a last minute decision for me. Okay. I'll let you know, dude. Jeez. I just want to see how the price action goes through the week. I shaved my beard in like February. Yeah, mid-February. Pretty much when the bull trend began, I shaved it and then it started growing back. And then I shaved it again. Oh, I shaved it again when the top kind of came in. After that that dump, I shaved it. And now it's back and we've broken out. So there is...
Mitch, are you going to hold excess steel through earnings in a couple of days or so and buy back in?
I'm already up 20%. I might take some profit. But the whole point of this one is like... I'm not looking at this as like a short-term thing. This for me is an extremely long-term position. This is a position trade. A position trade is where you hold an asset for like a year or two. Okay. Don't have many of those, but this one stuck out to me because the size of the pattern. All right, let's just think about the patterns we've been seeing kind of lately, like TripAdvisor and Sprint and ADA and Neo. All these patterns are really small. The most they started in crypto was in December of 2018, right? Big pattern, almost a year large, but this one started in December of 2015, its lowest point, right? So we're talking about a 4-year large pattern that has finally hit the PCZ, and on the tail end, it has showed a little falling wedge pattern, and we've now broken out of it, and I'm 20%. 20%, and it's gone nowhere.
Hey, Mitch, have a look at Keysight. Rising wedge, bearish dip, top of channel, 1.272 fib extension.
Sure, we'll look at Keysight. Yeah, thanks, Brett, man. Look at, all right, sorry, I gotta, crap. Should have looked at Grubhub first, my bad. So earnings shouldn't really be a big deal on a position trade. I mean, you know, it's like thinking too much. You don't want to think too much. I mean, like, it's barely gone anywhere. So yeah, I could dump and I could lose half the gains I made, but I would think in maybe a year I'd be up 10x plus on this asset if it makes just a common retrace, dude. Common retrace. Common retrace is $23. Golden retrace, $32.78. We're at $12 right now. So, you know, it's a good question, but I don't know. I might just hold it. you hold these, you forget about them, you have your stop set up, but you know, Bitcoin 9500 plus just briefly, about to be at 4 hour session highs, 32 minutes left till your daily close. All right, let me go to Grub Connect. This is what I'm talking about, dude. I guess it was already at levels of value, okay? This is Grub. Again, this thing's down 30% after hours. 39.65. Jesus. So this is where you are. Right there, this line. That's where you are. There's a gap fill. Down at like 35.20. Does seem extremely likely now, and since we're down here, we'd probably go down to touch that to test it. You're showing some divergence. The divergence was playing out, but guess what? Earnings will destroy your life. Boom. That's why you got to be careful. You got to be real careful. And it can be the other way, right? What if Grub reported really good earnings? It looked like, oh man, this thing's so exhausted, it's going to get wrecked. And then it just gaps up. Like, oh my God, that's earnings. Think about how underwater you'd be on a short here. That's why it's super scary to be playing that game. You're exposing yourself to risk. And as a trader, you want to be exposed to the least amount of risk possible for the highest amount of reward. All right, you're just gambling on earnings. Which you can do that if you want. But now let's look, man. Let's really look where that's going to put us on the most major retrace from the lowest low to highest high. All right. The 886. So that puts you below a 78% retrace. The 88% retrace, 3283, right where that gap fill is. So there's a reasonable targets to believe we would eventually get to on this gap down on terrible, terrible earnings. Get wrecked, Grubhub. Get wrecked. Hey, MK, how you doing, man? How's everything going in Cali? Yeah, dude, it's destroyed. It's been shattered into a million pieces. Wolverman, I don't know. Someone brought up one good one that I was looking at. I can't remember the ticker, dude. I look at so many freaking assets. I don't put everything on my watch list. It's just impossible. Some Aussie 85. Oh, excuse me. Actually, last time I looked at this was back in like May. This is Jeremy S's claim to fame. This is what made Jeremy S a legend in our community. Now there were many assets that looked very similar to this. The huge impulse down on the BTC pairs, and then they were creating the falling wedges with bullish divergence on the oscillators, and then this happened. You just couldn't predict which one was going to do it. Jeremy, I was like, hey, how's this, man? I'm like, yeah, dude, that looks beautiful. That looks great. And setting up for higher price. And then, bam, went up stupidly, like really stupid. I mean, so much that I was putting Ravencoin in my SEO and my titles and static videos. And I was getting views and all that because people were freaking out about Ravencoin. But, hey, it dumped from the low to high probably 78% of the way. And then kind of double bottom, rallied, lower high, dumped again, right? That's the story of Raven. But now, with a clean slate, we look again. Well, you're at a critical ice line. We know that. All-time lows. What a loser. Psh. Don't call Ravencoin a loser, man. So it's like, maybe we look at this in log scale. Log scale does absolutely nothing. Okay, great. I mean, it bounced pretty nice. Bullishly engulfing today. Never had a candle close below any of these critical areas. So maybe there's a chance, maybe on the weekly it looks better. See, maybe it's like an Eve and Adam double bottom developing, but dude, I'm getting no, like, nothing on the MACD or RSI on the weekly looks that good. Now it just looks like you might be at areas of value. That's about it. The bullish engulfing there. So I would say that I think you just got something like this going, man. Heartline, 75, heartline, not bad. So if you wanna break out, man, you're eventually gonna have to break this down sloping resistance. It does seem like, right, if you're looking at it bullishly, it's kinda like very high risk for a short up here. Or sorry, very, very high risk for a long here. Could be a shorting opportunity. So if you flip it over, maybe it's an area of value for a long because you're just at the bottom of a down, or you were near the bottom of a downtrend. But this thing's up so much. I mean, it was at 269 just a few days ago, and now it's at 334. So it's already increased a lot in value in a very short period of time. So yeah, you'd think that here's one high and here's your second attempt, your attempted rally, and you failed, made a lower high on candle closes. Sorry, a high or low on candle close. I'm thinking about it like this. Sorry. And yeah, there might be upside potential, but no real divergence. So I don't really like that I don't have any divergence on this. So normally I like having, not only being at critical supports and back testing, bouncing off them, I also like seeing impending price action reversal to the upside. It gives your argument a lot more validity, and then that's it, man. Okay, it's Ravencoin, man. I'm just looking at it because you asked for it. I would have never looked at this if you didn't ask. Okay, looks like crap. Thanks for the 600 people tuned in. Thanks for the 258 likes. If you haven't hit that like, or if you have not hit that like button or that sub yet, please do. If you want to see this channel continue to grow, we've been doing this for maybe a year and 9 months now. Close to a year and 9 months. And we're going to keep doing it all the time. Leonard C, thanks for the sub, dude. Welcome. Very cool. This is crazy. Tomo, the crypto is up 24% right now. Wild. Okay, so there's another one of those. ICX is up 3% today. All right, this is one that's kind of not that great. So you had this ice line. You held it initially, not enough demand, lower high, dumped again. And now you're back testing twice. Look, you broke the ice line, rallied, failed, dumped again. Here you are, exploding up to only hit this and not break it yet. You have not broken it. You did have divergence at the very end on the MACD and kind of on the RSI. All right, if you get the 4 hour, the way I have it plotted is here. It's beautiful. You know that not only are we outside of a crazy range that we're in for like almost a year, you know, we're also in a downtrend. And the only way to fix all this is break above this critical old support. Now you can use as resistance and then back test it as support again, and then break the down sloping resistance. And then you might be off to the races, might have a good chance, but you're not doing that yet. And Bitcoin's now at 9,300, now it's selling off. Okay, so maybe that 4 hour divergence had not played out all the way on Bitcoin. Let's go back to it. a lowest low of the 4 hour session. Here it is, right? Divergence, negative momentum's continuing to build now, which is okay. Looks like that hidden divergence not playing out yet. All right, so a little bit of a move, right? We're now down 2.3%, $220 on the day when we were just almost about to be in the green again. So selling pressure still not very great. Just sitting there, 22 minutes left to the daily close. Remember this trend line, how important it is. It's extremely important, man. It's the top of that range, that 121 day correction we were in. It's crazy, man. High on price, slightly higher high on price, lower levels relative strength. Class A bearish divergence, which signifies impending price action reversal to the downside. Well, you're getting it right now, but is it over? And that's the question I've been asking all day. I don't know if it's over yet, if this is played out or not, right? Okay, since Bitcoin, again, came to sell off a little bit, not too bad, not great, not terrible. Just want to know when this will finish up. I mean, there's always a chance we come back down to this area and test it again. And that's 89.71, not too far from where we are. See, I don't know, cup with handles on the 60 minute are extremely unreliable. So if you think it's a cup with handle, you're just looking at a pattern that you would want to see on the daily over like 2 months instead of a pattern that's been in development for like 3 days. That's just, they're very, very tenuous, even if they're real, okay? The more significant the time scale and the most amount of time, the more amount of time that goes by and with the development of that pattern, the stronger, the more reliable it's going to be. $9,212 we just saw, the lowest low of the session, the 4 hour session. 20 minutes to go, continuing to sell off a little bit more, not too bad, but again, we keep making those lows, keep selling off. And this would paint a 4 hour bearish engulfing candle, completely covering the previous candle before it. But again, not too bad, not yet, anyway. Yes, because we don't use, all right? If you're talking about divergence, let it be clear. Let you become learned. We do not use the wicks for divergence. We use the candle closes. Very important. Because did people settle their position up here? No, they settled their position here. They settled their position here, not here. All right, so that is why we use candle close or candle closes for our divergence. Hopefully, some of you that didn't know that now know that, and you can be Kang like us, all right? 92, just cracked 9,200 first time in a minute, right? Since Saturday, I think. Yep, 91.81. Continue to solve a little bit more, down 3.8%, $350. When just a few moments ago, we were only down about $50, big $300 move in only about 5 minutes or so. Oh man, it's getting dark in here again. Sun's going down on my side of town, dude. So I guess it's nighttime now. Let's change the conditions from partly cloudy to nighttime mostly cloudy. If you look in the top right of your screen, we've done it, man. The moon's out. The sun is no longer out. We did it.
Bruh.
Look here! Look, listen!
Leon, that good? Okay, got you.
Oh, fire sale. Oh my god, man, fire sale. Yeah, dude, 21 diet triple Jaeger shots, man.
So, yeah, I mean, like, again, there's just, compared to what we saw in volume on Friday, it's just nothing now. It's very minute. It's just consolidation that you're getting some sort of it. And I don't know when this is going to be complete. And I don't know if the hidden bullish divergence will ever play it on 60-minute. Because again, it's a 60-minute chart. It's not that reliable. But yeah, Brett, I got it. Nah, I was already, I mean, I have it up on my other screen. But I was going to look at it just, but we got kind of, you know, when there's market volatility on Bitcoin, you know how it goes. It's kind of like, we got to go to it. Cover it, make sure people know what's happening. I'm sure people aren't going to be looking for key sites when Bitcoin's dumping there and be like, I can't believe you, man. All right. Yeah, what's up, Crypto Schwab, man? You're back. You did it, dude. What's up, Ocean Toad? Chicago Crypto Hustler. Sending triangle again, man. You're just talking about a very small amount of data. It could just be, you could forget this and just look at it one and two. It's almost like you're building a wedge, maybe, or an upsloping flag or something at this point. Yeah, dude, I've only been live for an hour and 42 minutes. Crypto Schwab, so make sure to hit that like button, that bell, that sub if you haven't. Okay, thanks, dude. Thanks for the 640 people tuned in just watching Bitcoin move down a little bit. Nothing too bad. What's it look like on the daily? Well, on the daily, it looks like you're almost bearishly engulfing. But it's not a very big candle, but you did reject not once, but now today, for the second time, you've rejected a very critical historical resistance support back from May of 2018. You have to look left to see it. There it is. Well, yep. All right. Yes. Yes. So well below that now. Just no man's land. There's maybe 89,000 below you looking left. And that's it. So maybe we test this as support now. I don't know. Not really doing it. But I'm really concerned. I'm more concerned about this channel we've been in for so long, breaking out of it, holding outside of this long enough. I don't care how long it takes, as long as it can just, even if it gets all the way down to 8,500 outside of the channel, I'm cool with it. That might be a crazy area of value. Look left, right? So you broke it. What if in time you just create a flag or something, you know, and eventually backtest it? When it was once resistance, you would then confirm to the market that yes, it is a support still, and then you could bounce off of that. And that'd be a nice little correction too you could get. All right, you see what I'm saying? Big impulse, consolidation, big impulse, consolidation, and that is how it works. Okay, let me go to keys, kings. We'll keep our eye on it, chat. Almost nearly back up to 9,300 on the corn. 14 minutes left until your daily close. Beautiful, beautiful looking rising wedge, potentially. Extremely nice, Brett. Very, very good. Just awesome, man. Thanks for looking at an asset that looks like an extremely nice potential setup versus just asking about a random scrub coin or asset that has no opportunity for maybe a trade. And it's just like, okay, well, I was looking at it, analyzing it, no trade setup. Okay, you know, like, great. So your reasons. So this is one. Bearish divergence. Yep. It's like one, two, three. Not so much on the RSI. Maybe a little bit. not so clear on the RSI, but yeah, I guess you could say diverging some on that MACD, yeah. Just a little bit. I don't even know if we would consider that. You know, this is like here. We didn't even have positive momentum, right? We had it here. Something like that. A little bit of triple MACD bearish average, I guess. And he's like top of the channel too. Channel. This thing's going parabolic, kind of. It's legging up, which is cool. Oops, wrong tool. Not at the top of the channel. I like it like 1, 2, 3 on the top, 1, 2, 3 on the bottom. It's pretty nice like that, right? That's okay though, man, right? I mean, maybe you anchored from 1 and 2. I don't know. How did you anchor? It's almost like perfect for me. Anchoring that way with the channel. So let's go to the weekly on it. Oh man, did you even see the weekly, dude? How bad it is? It's like high on price, higher high on price, slightly higher high on price, even lower levels. Kind of there, you know, on the RSI too, but not as clear, right? I mean, this could be invalid in a second, maybe here too, but not bad. I think that's a really good looking channel. Don't you agree with me on my anchor points? It's not at the top, but let's look at major fib extensions from that previous high to low. Where are we? We're at a 1414 fib extension. So we're showing bearish divergence at a critical fib extension on the weekly and the wedge. Yeah, so there might be opportunity for short there. Yeah. Bearish possibility, man. I dig it, dude. I dig it a lot. Very nice. But, you know, it's just like sell off. You could hit the 1 6, you could hit 107.95 inside this wedge still somehow. It'd be crazy, but could happen. That's why layering in's a good idea, right? One can layer in some at the 1414 and then some at the 1618 or on the way to the 1618, right? Don't you agree? Could be possible. Keysight Technologies. Nice stuff, Brett, man.
Bruh.
Yeah, we're bearish engulfing on the daily. Correct. We sure are. I'm looking at it on my big screen. Bearish engulfing on the 4 hour as well. Negative momentum's just continuing to build on that 4 hour too. Okay, 9 more likes till 300. Is it possible at all? Anyone? I mean, if it's not, I get you, dude. But we have the technology and the numbers to get 300 likes. Easy. Keep around this. I'll put this on the watch list for sure. Very good. So we got 9 minutes till the daily close on Bitcoin. Just remember, from your highest point to lowest point, we did it a 50% retrace up here, or almost touched it perfectly. It's okay, Mr. Peabody, dude. Rest in peace, Longhorns. All right, so we're just running out of the clock now, making it to that 2 hour mark, making it to the daily close mark, just so we can see if there's what kind of price action we get leading up to it and maybe just a few minutes after it. Seems like you are, the day is closing with some weakness, a little bit of weakness. Just a little bit, not like a crazy amount, but yeah, again, engulfing, rejecting higher prices, rejecting resistance points from May of 2018. Go figure. Okay, great. Armando, yeah, people watch this because we make money. We know you don't, but that's okay, dude. So 92.25. Down $322, 3.38%. 6 minutes, 40 seconds left. Hey, what's up, Sergio, dude? Congrats on your gains with Nike and Farfetched, FTCH. Killing it, dude. What was the look here? Listen asset. I don't know. We did it like immediately. I think it was maybe FTCH. I'm trying to remember. So, yep. Engulfing, but still out of the downtrend. Wow. Big deal, man. What else are you doing in log scale? Seems like you are hitting an upsloping resistance, hitting a 25% trend line of the equidistant channel, hitting it and failing it for the third time. That upsloping trend line is confluent with the horizontal line resistance. Wow, go figure, right? So maybe with this first red candle since October 24th, we may begin consolidation, we may be flagging, whatever. I don't know, I think an ODP might be too high. I mean, it's like you had the entry and then that's it. Stupendous bounce off the bottom trend line and the hidden bullish divergence. A low, a higher low, much higher low, higher levels, negative memo. So, but yeah, again, it's like what happens when you hit resistance after, you know, running up 43% or something in less than 24 hours. Well, sometimes you sell off a little bit, not a big deal. We need the hype back. Okay, let's rewind to Friday. Magnum, they were okay, man. I think they're starting to make me break out a little bit, though, today. I don't know. Will Bitcoin fight back? Doesn't look like with 4 minutes left till your daily close. I think this is the, you know, this is why we try to stream for the daily close, because you start showing price action. Towards the end of the day, last 10, 30 minutes, hour of the day, you see stuff. MFCon, because futures are open 24/5. Right? They close on the weekend, but are open. They're like, it's like 4x. Am I crazy here? So we're at 93.85 on the futures. Okay, where were you? Just look left, man. Look
book left. Couldn't break it. On the gap up. Sell them off. Some. It's really not a big deal though, man. Remember, there's the gap down here, and there's the gap. And on the daily, it's there. It's like way up here. Yeah, 11.9 or 8.7. The poll we did, the small majority of y'all said that we would see 8,700 before 11.9. All right. Sorry, this is log. My bad. There you go. Not log. Outside of the channel, dude. So we got 2 minutes, chat. So we'll just go ahead and do it. The one that gets on my gun.
Bruh.
Seeing the gaps fill, but you might be waiting forever. Make you feel more comfortable, but it's just one variable. I mean, it'd be hilarious for it to not fill, get really close, and then run up to fill the 11.9 gap. And then people be like, oh my god, man, I can't believe it. Why have you forsaken me, gap fill? So really not too bad. But let's see if we ever get another touch on this trend line, if there's follow-through price action on this candle. One minute, chat. Just hanging out, running out the clock. Okay? What's up, Nippon Cowboy? 92.18. 20 seconds left till that daily close. Sweet. Ten seconds. 92.16. There it is, chat. A new day has been born. Excellent. All right, we made it, man. We made it to another daily candle opening. Old one closing. Out the gate, nothing happening in the first 30 seconds. Just a little bit of selling. It's whatever, man. All right, always a chance, you know, like maybe you're looking at the 4 hour and trying to make sense of it, 60 minute trying to make sense of it, but maybe on the daily something needs to develop. We have like no data, just three white soldiers maybe, and now we're just had a red candle today. Tomo's up 2.5% right now. What? Tronconex up 4% on the new day. What? How's this happening, dude? How's it happening? Let's tell our heel. Oh, yeah. Let's look at that 200-day moving average. Yeah, always could. Sure. Could back test it as support. You're not far. I mean, you don't even have to go anywhere. Eventually, the 200 will catch up. Candles, yeah, you could touch it again. That's wonderful, though. Getting back above that, extremely important. And also, we're looking at the Gaussian tool. The Gaussian. Oops, wrong. MFCon, thanks for the one, dude. The Gaussian. So, as of, you know, earlier today, we were above the inner Gaussian band, now not really sure, kind of like at it, right? Kind of closed right freaking at it. So still in the red, but it's a lagging indicator. Okay, so like what you had to do before was on the daily, you had eventually had to break above it and hold above it for a little while. And once you did that, good things happened. So really would like to see Bitcoin stay above the Gaussian inner band and hold and do whatever it needs to at that point. And that'd be great, man. That'd just be a good thing to see. All right. Because you don't want to be below the Gaussian inner band. You want to be above it. That's it. Whoa, Mr. Peabody, whoa. I don't think you're worried about it. After that almost $5 million deal you closed on Friday, dude. I think that's, no one cares about a Gaussian tool if you're you, dude. Anyway, 92.27, man. Above the 200-day moving average, right at the Gaussian and outside of the downsloping channel. So the things you need to see for a reversal to the upside, we're beginning to show them, we're beginning to do those things, but we're not out of the woods yet. So there are other things you must do, and those things include breaking previous historical overhead resistance points and then back testing them as support when they were once resistance. And then after holding that a while, you break to the upside. You break new ones, you break the old ones, right? Sorry, you say new as in like, it's where you are at the time. You break resistance, and you consistently break resistance, hold, consolidate, run again. You do that over and over and over. What did we do here? And it was like, happened really fast, 6-month period, but it was like impulse up, consolidated from April 3rd to April 28th, almost a month of consolidation on Bitcoin after that initial, well, not the initial, this was the initial one, hype, the Gartley PCZ. But here, once we made this April 1st big move up, 1 month consolidation, and then we ran again, and then went from May 13th to June 11th, almost an entire month of consolidation again, before running once more, the buying climax. So, it takes time after you have big moves like this. I mean, we had the largest daily volume on Bitcoin on Friday that we had seen since the actual buying climax of the crazy move. So Bitcoin 9261, up a little bit on the new day. All right, that's great, dude. No big deal. I just, it's really like, it's more clear when you see this develop, okay, than when you just made the impulse a few days ago and now you're sideways. You're out of the channel. You should be happy, chat. You should be real happy. You should be engaged. You should be super hyped for this stuff. Thanks for the 700 people still here, and thanks for the 336 freaking likes, chat. Y'all are amazing. Really cool. Been live for over 2 hours now. So anything over 2 hours is overtime. 9251. Great, dude. Let's go the 4 hour again, I guess. Really not that crazy, man. It's still really strong. Pivoting here, or even here, 89.73, whatever. Thanks, Trader Mark. And Mark B. Oh, both Marky Marks. Also, Theron Harris, Adrian A. Hey, what's up, Kevin Grubb? That's it. It's over. Shut it down, man. It's all over for Bitcoin. I guess we're going to zero. Time to start using the, whatever, the butthole indicator. the sequential butthole indicator to show us we're going to zero, man. What'd Matt say? Total crypto market cap dropped lower to 246 billion with Bitcoin dominance at 67.7%. I don't think it moved on that chart we look at. No way it's at 67% unless it crashed almost. It dumped really hard. I don't think so, man. There's no way. Yeah. Oh, it's 69.9%, right? Okay. 70% Bitcoin market dominance on this chart, so not 67 right now anyway. According to this chart. Great.
Bruh.
All right, man. Well, I've done my thing, which was analyze Bitcoin, altcoins, stocks, many things across the markets. That's what it's called. So, all right. I'll just, get out of here and leave you to it. You should have a better understanding, maybe, of Bitcoin at this point. And hopefully, if you don't think I covered Bitcoin enough, then go watch my effing static video that was like 12, 13 minutes long from today. Check it out. So thanks, Tom Jones, for the 6180 Session Top Jesus. Really appreciate that. Coming in hot. And everyone else, Maria for the 20. Y'all are amazing. Okay. So I'll just be back later. Until then, respect the T. A. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Oh, hey, Marco Rivera. Rivera.
Thank you. Turd nuggets.